I'm David Hanley, the University of Maine Cooperative Extension Small Fruit and Vegetable Specialist, and today we're going to talk about selecting a site for planting your blueberries. Now, when we look for a site for blueberries, one of the first things you want to do is select a site that's open and not shaded. Although blueberries will tolerate shade, if you're after these plants for production, in other words, lots of berries, then they should get full sunlight. If you're primarily interested in having them in the landscape and feeding the birds, then sure, go ahead and put them in a partially shaded area. But just understand you're going to lose a little bit of fruit when you go down that lane. Now, the other thing you want is a little bit of protection. Blueberries are not adequately hardy for all parts of Maine. So if you can have a hedge or something running along the west and north sides to prevent those cold winds from coming and hurting those delicate buds in the wintertime, that will help quite a bit. One of the things you don't want to use for a hedge, though, is balsam fir. Balsam fir exchanges some disease problems, specifically witch's broom, with blueberries, so that's not a particularly good plant to have around your blueberries. But some other kind of evergreen hedge will help them get through the winter much better. The other thing you want to be near is a source of water. These plants need water not only for establishment, but through the fruiting season, especially if we're facing a very dry summer, you want to be able to get water to those plants. So get some place where you can either run a hose to them, some trickle irrigation or a soaker hose, to keep those roots well rooted during the summertime. Now, in terms of soil types, blueberries like a well-drained soil, and this is a mistake gardeners often make. They think blueberries grow in the swamp, so I'm going to plant them in a wet, soggy part of my lawn. That's not really the case. Blueberries will tolerate wet during the late fall and winter and spring, in other words, when they're dormant. But during the growing season, if their roots are in water, the plants will drown and you'll lose them. So pick a well-drained soil. In other words, don't look for a spot where the water stands in the spring. Stay away from there. Go a little further uphill where the water drains away quite nicely. Blueberries don't like heavy soils, so we want to stay away from areas that are loaded with clay. They prefer a sandy or sandy loam type soil, something that drains well and is nice and friable, like we see here. Lots of big chunks in this soil. It will drain very well. The roots will be able to grow through there very well. This is the type of soil that we're looking for. If your soil has a lot of clay or is compacted, you need to work a lot of organic matter into that soil to loosen it up, to improve the drainages, and help those roots grow better. Some of the things we can add to the soil to help improve that. Peat moss is very typically used for blueberries because they like a lot of organic matter and they tend to grow in peat-type soils in the wild anyway. Peat moss is a little bit expensive, but if you're just growing a few plants, this will work quite well. Remember to wet it before you incorporate it into the soil. If you incorporate it in dry, it actually acts like a sponge and will suck that moisture right out of the soil. The other thing we can use is compost. Compost is just a nice source of organic matter. It will also help loosen up the soil. It can be less expensive than peat moss, especially if you make it yourself. Just make sure it's got good drainage, and also be aware that the pH of your compost can be quite high sometimes, and blueberries like an acid soil. We'll talk more about that in a minute. You can also use other sources of organic matter, things like sawdust, for example, but bear in mind if you use something like sawdust or just leaves or pine needles worked into the soil, they can rob the soil of nitrogen, because as the bacteria in the soil tries to break that down, it will pull the nitrogen out of the soil, make it less available to your blueberry plants, and you may find you're having a real tough time keeping those blueberries adequately fertilized. So I prefer something that's already broken down, like compost, well-rotted sawdust, or just some peat moss pre-moistened before you work it into the soil. Now, in terms of preparing your soil and getting ready for that, this should be done in the fall before planting. Of course, have a soil test taken. Stop at your cooperative extension county office, pick up a soil test box, get the little form, make a soil test the way they tell you. We have a video on that at this website that you can look at. But be sure on the form that you fill out blueberries, because blueberries have some very specific nutritional needs, and you don't just want to put a general garden code on here. Make sure you code for blueberries. They'll come back and tell you what you need to do, but one of the things you need to be aware of is that blueberries are acid-loving plants. They're in the same family as rhododendrons, azaleas, mountain laurels, that group. They like their soil to be acid or sour. Usually what we're looking for is a pH of about 4.8 to 5.2. Typically, if you're going into soil that's had lime, like a lawn or a garden, your pH is going to be up around between 6 and 7. So you may need to acidify that soil. And what they'll recommend is that you put some sulfur on it. And you can buy sulfur in little pelletized form like this, or you can buy it in a powdered form. Your soil test will tell you exactly how much you need to add per square foot to bring that pH down to the desired level of 4.8 to 5.2. This should be worked into the soil, preferably the fall before planting, so it has time to break down and adjust that pH for you. Now, when we're going to plant these things, we want to work some organic matter into the soil. Now, you can do this the fall before if you want. You can add some compost to the soil, or you can work a cover crop in, such as winter rye or oats or buckwheat, one of those things. But when we actually plant the plants, we'll be working some compost and some other organic matter right into the soil. Typically, what I recommend is when you dig a hole for blueberries, you take the soil that you've taken out of that soil, out of that hole, and mix it one-to-one with your organic matter, such as compost or peat moss. Just work it right in there, and this is what we're going to backfill around the plant once we plant this in the springtime. So we'd put the plant in, backfill with this one-to-one mixture of organic matter and soil, and our pH is at the proper level because we put sulfur in the fall before, and we'll be all set. So the primary things to remember are full sunlight, protection against the wind, a good source of water, good drainage in your soil, and correct your pH to 4.8 to 5.2, and you'll be all set. The last thing we want to talk about is weed control. One of the things we don't want to do is dig right into a lawn, just dig a hole in a lawn and stick your bush in there, because the grass will quickly come back in and compete with the roots of these blueberries. These blueberry roots are only about 6 to 8 inches deep. So you need to kill out any grass or weed species that are on that soil prior to planting. You can do this with a lawn herbicide if you want, the fall before, to kill it out and plant into it the next year. You can do it by working that grass up the year before and making sure that it's not going to come back by working it repeatedly. Or you can just do something like laying some old landscape fabric down or some old plastic that you might have lying around, tar paper, whatever. Put that down on the ground for several months, and this will kill out all the grass underneath. When you pull this up in the springtime, you'll have a nice bare patch there that won't have many weeds in it. Plant directly in it without working the soil up, because that'll disturb more weed seeds to come up, and you'll find that you put that plant in, mulch around it, and you'll have very few weed problems afterwards. So that's how to get your site ready for blueberries. In a little while, we'll talk about actually planting these things.